So you want to make an amazing story, an amazing comic or book, and you're kind of stuck because maybe you have too many ideas and you do not know how to juggle all of them together, and you're stuck, essentially. Hello everyone, I am MG and I am going to show you one of the most beautiful parts of making a comic or a book, and that's making an outline. So let's start with the basics. What is an outline? An outline is a perfect way to organize your thoughts. For many creatives, it's about writing the whole story from beginning to end. An outline is like a plan for your story. It breaks down the things that are going to happen in a chronological order in your story, from beginning to end, as I said. Don't worry about including all the details, that comes later as you progress in the story. It's just a guide and you can go away from it. Hold on there, especially if you're a comic writer. You hate the idea? Is this your first story ever? You never use this? How many stories have you finished? You don't have to make an outline for your story if you don't want to. It's about you making your own rules and trying out new things to make your story better. Maybe comic creators do not know this too well because they usually do not write the story as well, but many writers in the real world do know about this. Some of them hate it, some of them love it. Personally, I love it because it was the solution for many problems that I have. I have written a lot of comic stories, but I always had some troubles with them and I didn't know how to fix them until I met the outlining process. So, as I give you 4 reasons why I love it, I am going to show examples within those reasons. Some of them are self-explanatory, so I won't tell you much about them, but the more technical outlining method that I am going to show you, I will explain that one. Reason number 1 to use an outline. It avoids plot holes. You can have awesome events, but maybe you do not even have a why it happens. And that's very comic, very common with comic artists. Maybe you have A and C on your story, but you don't even have a B. An outline definitely helps filling that gap. For example, here I am using a non-technical method of outlining, which is a timeline. Reason number 2 to use an outline. It ends the I never finish my story syndrome. You already know what to do if you have a very good outline. You don't have even to shield yourself under artist's block or writer's block because you always know what to do. Yes, it's a creative process, you are creating the story, you're creating an outline. But after you get over that outline, the rest is history and it's much easier. Doesn't matter if you're tired, you have exact steps of what to do. And really, it is helpful if you have a very busy life and you want to create still a very amazing story. You can have yourself on check with the story. In this example, you are seeing a mind map. This is for people who have a very large and long story, maybe world building. And there are technical rules. If you want to check out rules, you can check the link I am going to put in the description. But remember, do whatever you want and what works for you. In this mind map, I'm using Harry Potter as an example because it has lots of elements and I am pretending like if I was J.K. Rowling writing it for the first time without knowing what to expect. After you do that mind map, you put groups in chronological order or sections that are within each kind of element, and then those sections can become the chapters. This kind of outlining usually becomes the next kind of outlining that we are going to show. Reason number 3 to use an outline. It avoids unnecessary rumble. If you do not have an outline, and this was a common problem for me, chances are that you have a great imagination and you start coming up with different ideas, with many ideas that do not have anything to do with your story. Maybe you want to put the flashback of the evil soldier that is guarding the cell where your protagonist is captive or something, but there's a rule, a basic rule in storytelling, that if there's a part of the story that doesn't help push the story forward, then it's unnecessary. You shouldn't put it in, and in fact, it makes the story slower and less interesting. So having an outline definitely prevents you from doing that. In this example, you are seeing bullet points. It's a non-technical way of doing an outline, and this is the one I personally use for my comics, and I love it. I think it's super clear and it helps you avoid plot holes, as I said, and it helps me to just have like an instructions for art block or writer's block, or when I don't feel like it, I always know what to do. So reason number four to make an outline: it lets you see if your story is actually interesting. If your story is really interesting in the things that happen, you will see it on your outline. And you will be even more motivated to do it, because you are like, oh, I cannot wait for this part for my readers to see. They are going to be so shocked, and you're going to be more excited. If your story is not interesting, you will start noticing it. If you read your outline and you are bored, that means that you have to correct and probably show it to someone else so you have a second opinion. As I said, there are many technical ways of making an outline. I will link resources in case you want to go deeper into this down below. Personally, I do not think that you have to go that far. I use the bullet point method, and the methods that I'm showing here are not that difficult, and they are, except maybe the mind map, but maybe it's useful if you have a very complex world-building story. Yes, I am a huge fan of outlining, but you are the creator. You make the rules. Do whatever you want. You create your story. So yes, that's all that I got for today. Now, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe on that red button over there. And if you want to learn more about comics, art, and even lifestyle, comment down below, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!